We just traveled Mexico for 10 weeks and we had a really good time. One of the questions we get asked the most is Mexico a safe place to visit? If you've been reading travel advices and looking up online, you might be forgiven for thinking that Mexico is a really unsafe destination where crime is rampant.
But Mexico is actually a very beautiful country and one of our favorite countries we've visited so far. If you take a few precautions, you'll probably have a very good time in Mexico and be very, very safe. I'm Kim.
And I'm Mike.
And together we are going to delve into our top tips for staying safe in Mexico.
In our experience in traveling Mexico for 10 weeks, we have only met really nice people.
Super.
We have experienced the Mexican people as being very nice, very warm, very friendly, always helpful when we needed something. If you need to ask directions or just saying hi when you're walking in the streets, we have only had good experiences. Most of the violence here is related to the drug cartels. And it's really gang wars, which are just that. It's wars between gangs and they're really not targeting tourists. Which brings us to our first step. Stay away from drugs. Don't buy any drugs. Don't use any drugs. Stay away from prostitution.
You will be offered both. If you go to a club, for example, there will be a man standing next to the line at the bathroom asking you if you want to sniff some coke. The best thing to do if you're concerned about your safety would be to politely decline. There are some reports you can read online and some articles in media outlets that speak about people being shot, for example, in Cancun or Tulum or Playa del Carmen, tourists being shot as part of a gang war. The chances of that happening are so small. If you steer clear of everything that has to do with the cartel, they most likely won't be interested in you. They're not standing on street corners trying to organize petty theft. They're trying to sell millions of coke and millions of marijuana. They don't really care about the tourists that visit the area. Yep. So another thing, aside from drug wars and cartel related shootings that a lot of people are concerned about when they come to Mexico, are kidnappings, because it's something that you read about online, because it's sensational, you know, it makes for a dramatic headline.
Yeah.
So it really sticks into your brain if you come across an article like that. The reality of it is that kidnappings aren't a part of common life in Mexico. When you hear about these kidnappings, sometimes you'll hear that someone got into the wrong taxi. You can avoid that risk in the first place by taking an Uber taxi. It's super safe, it's super cheap.
Yeah.
You can just see who will be your driver in the app.
Tracked by GPS, they have the name of the driver, so it's a very safe way of getting around. And we also really had good experiences with these Uber drivers as well. They were generally friendly, gave us good tips.
If anything, these guys will help you stay safe.
Yeah.
Because they were the people who told us, well, don't go to that neighborhood, too late. They're really just nice people trying to help. And the app and all the securities that come with it give you a little bit of peace of mind about your safety.
And it's cheap too.
It's cheap.
You might have heard some stories about buses being held up at gunpoint and people being kidnapped. First of all, we would recommend to not travel at night, unless you're really sure it's a safe place to travel around at night. Ask around and do some research to find out what are the recommendations on that location. Take direct buses and first class buses. These buses go directly from point A to B. They don't stop on different spots along the road.
And again, these kidnappings are a rare thing. I think it especially happened more in the past. I wouldn't be too concerned with it, as it's very unlikely that you will encounter something like this on your trip. If there is one risk in Mexico that is a bit more realistic than the stuff we've talked about so far, it is the chance of getting pickpocketed or getting robbed. Like in a lot of other places in the world, but there are a lot of precautions you can take in order to prevent that from happening, like not flashing your valuables, don't wear $20,000 Rolex, if you own one. We don't even own one, so we don't have that problem.
I don't even have a watch with me.
No, just be your broke-ass self and you'll be fine. Don't flash about your expensive camera. Now, I do have to nuance this because, of course, we make travel videos. I mean, we walked around with our camera like this, talking to the camera. But if you're not using it, why not just put it away? Same for your phone, not using it, just put it in your purse or in your pocket or whatever.
In the unlikely event that you do get robbed, be sure to stay calm and to cooperate. These people are not out there to harm you, but they're just out there to make a quick buck. So just give them your money or your wallet or your phone and they will just on their way.
Also make sure to have some cash on you in different places. Don't put all of your money in your wallet. Instead, put a little bit in your wallet and a little bit in your pocket or in your sock or another safe place, wherever you want to put it. Put it in your bra. I put mine in my bra, I'm not kidding.
Put mine in my...
Yeah, you don't have boobs yet. Man boobs. That way, if you do get mugged, you give them your wallet and you still have a little bit of money left. Take a taxi back to your hotel, make sure you get out of the situation safely.
It's also important to know which areas to avoid. If you take Mexico City, for example, you can walk around safely in most of the neighborhoods there, but there are some rough neighborhoods that are better to avoid. It's good if you do some research up front, ask around in your hotel or hostel or in the restaurant you're visiting. These people live and work there and they really know where places are that you can go.
If you're going to go out after dark, make sure not to get lost exploring into these small side lanes and ending up in neighborhoods you don't want to be. And in case you do get lost, try not to look lost. Try not to take out a big tourist map and stand in the middle of the street looking around like this.
Just on your phone, turning your phone like this, like you really... Just be confident, act like you know where you're walking, just walk around the block a bit to see if you recognize some street or something.
And if you're going to go ask someone for directions and you're in a neighborhood that feels a bit sketchy but you need to ask someone, don't just ask any guy hanging around the street corner, walk into a small shop, buy some water and say, hey, do you happen to know where this is?
We always find it's very important to buy a local SIM card to make sure that you have some data on your cell phone. In the case that you do get lost or you don't know how to get somewhere, quickly grab out your phone, see where you are and immediately you know the right direction.
Download Google Maps offline for the area where you are.
Or the app maps.me also allows you to download offline maps.
Offline maps. That means you're out there, you don't have 4G, you don't have data, but you can still locate yourself on the map and find your way back to the hotel, even without the internet. And that's a pretty good backup in case you find yourself lost.
Yeah.
Lost or just wondering. I often find myself wondering, where the hell am I? You may have also heard some stories about credit card fraud in Mexico. Yeah. It does happen every now and then. And there are some things you can do to prevent that from happening. For example, try to use cash payments as much as you can. Don't just go into any store and give them your credit card. Try to only do that at more expensive restaurants or places that seem like they are very trustworthy. Yeah. Even if you do so, no matter who you hand it to, try to keep your credit card within eyesight. So try to never let anyone take it into this small little back room. Keep an eye on it.
It's also important to check your bank statements regularly so that if something does happen, you can immediately call the bank and they can block your card and they just refund you the money. It's also important to stick to ATMs that are inside bank buildings. These are safe for yourself, like people don't really see you how much cash you're taking, but also they cannot be rigged because we've read some reports about certain cash machines that are like in the streets which have been rigged and then just copy your bank card. So to avoid using them and just use the one inside the bank.
Even though there is a small chance that something bad would happen to you when you come to Mexico, credit card fraud or you get pickpocketed, there are a lot of places in the world where that can happen and this is just one of them. Even though there is that risk, there is a far, far greater chance that you will come out of Mexico with nothing but great memories and nothing bad at all happening to you, just like it was the case for us.
Yeah.
We spent 10 weeks in Mexico, nothing bad happened.
Yeah, and we met hundreds of travelers and we didn't really hear about anything really bad happening to any of those people, so most likely you'll be very fine.
Yeah.
And a little bit fatter because of the tacos.
Yeah. Maybe a little bit hungover because of the cervezas.
That's
awesome. We hope this video was able to inform you a bit, to help you out, to give you some tips, but also to reassure you.
If you liked our video and thought it was helpful, please leave a like and leave a comment below. Also, if you have some additional safety tips or recommendations for Mexico, leave them down below. We just arrived here in Guatemala and we'll be continuing onwards onto Colombia and Brazil, after which we will fly to Asia somewhere. We don't know where yet, but we will continue traveling for
quite a while longer.
Quite a while longer.
Yes. And if you're interested in watching videos from Guatemala and whatever is next to come, make sure to click the subscribe button. And next to the subscribe button, you will find a small bell button. Ring that. In case you want to be notified by email whenever we have new videos, so you can be the first to watch it.
All right. See you guys.
See you in the next one. Bye.